Hi! In the last lesson, we provided an overview of the course and motivated the need for software engineering. In this lesson, we will present and start discussing several traditional software engineering lifecycle models. We will talk about their main advantages and also about their shortcomings. We will also talk about classic mistakes in software engineering, that is, well-known ineffective development practices that, when followed, tend to lead to bad results. And covering those will hopefully help us to avoid them in the future. And because in this lesson I will discuss some fundamental aspects of software engineering, to suitably introduce these topics, I went to the University of Southern California to interview one of the fathers of software engineering, Professor Barry Bohem.
Well, a software lifecycle is a sequence of decisions that you make, and fundamentally those decisions are going to determine the history of the software that you are going to build that other people are going to use. And the process model is basically answering the question of what shall I do next and how long shall I do it for? And again, because there are a lot of different ways you can make that decision, you need to figure out which models are good for which particular situation. So, for example, we've written a book that's called Balancing Agility and Discipline. It says, under what conditions should you use agile methods, under which conditions should you invest more time in analyzing the situation and planning what you're going to do and the like. And so, if the project is small, where it's 3 to 10 people, Agile works pretty well. If it's 300 people, then you don't want to go that way. If the effect of a defect is loss of comfort or limited funds, then Agile is fine. But if it's a loss of life, then you don't. On the other hand, if you have a situation where you have a lot of unpredictable change, you really don't want to spend a lot of time writing plans and lots of documents and things like that. And in some cases, you may have a project where you want to do waterfall in some parts and agile in others and so on. So these are the kind of things that make the choice of life cycle process model very important and very interesting as a subject of research.